there's this bench that like all of us would hang out at, and like they would just like roll out the linoleum, we'd just get down right there.
Wow.
Yeah.
So man, you got that's man, you must have went to a crazy high school, man. It's just like B-boys and DJs and you said people with instruments and all kind of stuff. That's dope.
Yeah, it's crazy. Yeah.
So like when you get to your first competition, how was that?
Oh man.
Before you get into it, I'll share a quick story with you, cuz the first competition I actually went to, right? Mm-hmm. Was True to the Game in San Jose.
Oscar Smile.
That was Yeah, it was in, I believe, 02. What? I think it was 02. It was like True to Game 2, I believe.
Yeah, man, yeah, yeah.
It was like a who's who of the future B-boy legends from the West. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, I think they had Cali versus Vegas, so all the heavy, the up-and-comings from Vegas were there. All the up-and-comings from Cali. I think you guys might have, were you guys...
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know if all you guys were in there, but I know at least Courage was in there, I believe.
Yep.
Right?
Yeah. So So the first one, there was a Bay versus LA, and then the Bay versus LA one, Roland was in, and Rocks, right, and all of them. But like, I think Roland was the only one that was in that one. And then on the Bay versus Vegas one, me, Courage, and Roland, and actually Rob, another guy in Headhunters, we were all on that team. And then was crazy.
Yeah, that was a dope jam, because I remember like a lot of the people who went on to be like some of the top B-boys out of the country were in that building then. You know what I'm saying? I remember I even saw Reveal there, and I ain't gonna front, man, I was shook. I went in there, I'm like, me and my cousin went, and I was like, yo, we gonna go to this jam. You know what I'm saying? I was like, it's right here in San Jose, and I'm gonna drive out, and we're gonna go, and we're gonna check it out, man. And the whole day, my cousin was like, when you gonna get down? When you gonna get down? And I was like, nah, I don't like this song, man. This ain't my song right here. But so that's kind of like my San Jose connection right there. You know what I'm saying?
Man, being my that's first crazy.
Jam. That is crazy, man. But anyway, what about your first jam experience?
So my first jam, actually, I didn't compete at. It was like the first event that I went to was like a show, but it was like a hip hop show. And I remember, I think Style Elements were there, and they were performing. I forgot with who, but they were there. And I remember being like in a cypher. But like the cypher wasn't like hella B-boys. It was just like Style Elements and then Trademark and then a few just like locals. And I think it was in Santa Cruz. And we went over there, and I was like, whoa, like it was like in a theater, like in a, like a amphitheater spot. And then
wow,
it was huge. I was like, whoa, this is crazy. But like, it wasn't hella packed. It was just like hip hop heads there, you know, like just like down, like, you know what I mean? Like what did they call them before, like backpackers or whatever,
Right,
you know what I
right.
mean? So like there's a bunch of hip hop heads there, and then so there's b-boys, you know, DJs, MCs, and like just and not there wasn't hella b-boys, it was just like Style Elements and Trademark and then the locals. So like getting down, I was like scared to get down because I'm like I already saw footage of Crumbs and Remind, and I was like, dude, these guys are like insane. Like,
Right,
you know
right.
what I mean?
They're at
Like
the top of the game.
immediately, yeah, immediately, like I like looked up to them and I was like, dude, these guys are sick. Like, who the heck are these dudes? You know what I
Right, I
mean?
can
Like,
imagine.
how did they get this crazy? You know, like all these just watching them in the cipher, like I didn't even want to get down, you know? Like, what
Right.
was I? Like, I was like still like a year in, you know what I mean? So
Right.
I'm like, I don't
So
know
you
if
had
I'm
the
gonna
same
get
feeling
down.
I had, like,
Yeah.
and then you get there, you're like, ooh, I don't know about this. You know what I'm
Yeah.
saying? So, but yeah, man, that's dope. So
Yeah.
now this, so far you've been telling us these stories, and it's all been under Trademark, right? So when
Yeah.
does Trademark convert to
To
the
Headhunters.
Headhunters? When I used to watch my
Yeah.
old B-Boy Summit tapes and all that, the
Yeah.
Headhunters.
Dude, so it started off like Courage and Roland, they're a couple years, I think 3 years older than me. So when I was a I think when I was a sophomore, they were seniors, so they were ready to cut out, you know what I mean? So at that time, like I think they were like super busy, so I started I still continued to practice in the hallways at school, and I met Deja Vu, Adriatic, Ro, and Mike Amon, and all four of them, they went to middle school together, and but they were in the hallways breaking, and like we would just like get down, and then Deja Vu, he hits me, he comes up to me, he's like, hey, let's practice, man. I'm like, where, my spot? And they're like, yeah. And I'm like, yeah, I'm down. I don't really practice with anyone. And then, like after that, we were just like, after school, go to my spot, practice. And then that was just like going, continuously going like throughout the school year. And then next thing you know, like, we're all like, why don't we come up with a crew? And then we're like, yeah, I mean, we're already practicing together, you know, let's do it. So we were like, what should we be called? And this is the funniest part, because we're like, how about, we were just throwing out names, and then we Deja Vu goes, how about Innocent Bystanders? And then we're like, at the time we're like, dude, that's cool. Innocent Bystanders Crew, IBC, you know what I mean? We're like, you know, like we're like, that's dope. Let's do it. Innocent Bystanders Crew. And then so we're like Innocent Bystanders Crew. And then Vu goes, hey, do you still talk to Roland? And then I was like, man, I haven't talked to him in a while. Like, I think it was like a year and a half or something where we lost contact. And then, because I was already a sophomore, I think. So then I was like, yeah, I haven't talked to them, and da da da, you know. And then I was like, I'll try to hit them up. And then I got in touch with them, and then he came over, and we're like, yo, we practiced. And then after practice, we were like, yo, we're starting a crew, like you want to be down? And he was just like nonchalantly like, yeah. So he was just like nonchalantly like, yeah, I'm down. I'm down to like be in the crew, you know? And then he goes, what's this crew called? We're like Innocent Bystanders Crew. And he's like, all right. And then so we just ran with that name for a little while, a little while was like maybe like 2 3 months. And then he was go we oh so there's a competition coming up, and we already got Roland down, we and then we got robbed down around the same time. So at the time, I was going to this one practice spot in San Jose called Soul, and it was at a church. And like our friend Jason Ma was the one running it, and he would just be like, "Yo, just come by and practice at the church. Like, you know, like it's all good. We have floor, and you know, we have music, and like, 'cause there would be a DJ there every, I think it was like a Tuesday or something. We'd go there every Tuesday and just get down." Yeah, so we would go to this spot called Soul every Tuesday just to get down, and that's where I met Rob. And then Trademark was actually going there too, but we weren't I don't they were they would practice there, but then they would also practice at other spots. And I was already practicing at my house, so it wasn't like, "Yo, come by and practice here," and like it wasn't like that. So like we got rolling down, we got robbed down, and then a jam was coming up, and in Palo Alto, and it was a 3-on-3. Roland was like, "Yo, let's enter that 3-on-3, me, you, and Rob." And I was like, "I'm down. Let's do it." And then Roland was like, "Yo, let's enter as headhunters." And I was like, "Whatever, you know, let's enter as headhunters." And then we entered the jam, and then I think Ro, Adriatic, and Deja Vu, or actually, you know, Mike Amon, Deja Vu, and Adriatic entered as innocent bystanders. And then so like we had headhunters and innocent bystanders, right? And so for after that jam, like everyone knew us as headhunters because we like got to the finals, I think. And that but we lost. And then but people knew us as headhunters, and then that wasn't my first jam that I entered, but they knew us as headhunters. And then for like maybe like a year or so, we were IBC slash HH. So like but then we finally were just like, "All right, let's just stick to headhunters." Like it's kind of like the two names are kind of like clashing. You know what
We're innocently bystanding, but at the same time, we're attacking and hunting
I
heads.
mean? Yeah. So we stuck with headhunters, and then yeah, we just rolled with it. But we joke around still today, like IBC, IBC, you know what I mean? But yeah, that was how we got the headhunter's name out. And then soon after that, Chez, Courage, Scooby got down, and then that's how we just became a crew.
No doubt. Now
Yeah.
you guys were pretty at least by the time I see you guys, right? Because by the time I see you guys, it's all headhunters, and you guys are doing like some of the bigger jams now, right? So this is like
Yeah.
01, 02 time frame, right?
Yeah.
Now
Yeah.
you guys were, in my opinion, you guys were down. What they say today, wanted to smoke. Y'all was down for the smoke. So y'all was always like
Yeah.
aggressive and very like, you know, forthright with like, "We here, what's up?" So
Yeah.
that means that you guys probably had rivals for sure.
Yeah.
Who were some of your rivalries that pushed you guys to get even that much better?
We started we had rivals with a crew called Then we started having beef with Ground Zero. It was crazy, man.
Wait,
And
time out,
then
time out, time out. Everything else was a rivalry, but you specifically used the word beef when you said Ground Zero. What happened?
And we it was weird because I feel like
For more quality content from Beyond Decipher with Ill Skills, don't forget to press the like and subscribe buttons. Let us know how we're doing down in the comment section, and to make sure that you don't miss anything from the channel, smash that notification bell. We appreciate the love and support. Peace until the next episode.